More on the weather now, and four people remain in hospital this morning after being struck by lightning at the Opera House during that monster storm that struck Sydney. The wild weather caused commuter chaos and power outages with more than 300 calls for help, and a massive clean-up is underway this morning. Joining us now is SES Chief Superintendent Dallas Burns and Senior Meteorologist from the Bureau, Angus Hines. Good morning to you both. Chief Superintendent, to you first. How damaging was that storm?
Yeah, we saw a lot of damage across the Sydney Basin and into the Hunter yesterday. Over 100 jobs in the Hunter and what we call our northern zone, and another 200-odd jobs in the Sydney Basin. Still 66 outstanding to complete this morning, but our volunteers have been busy yesterday afternoon and overnight to knock those jobs over, mainly due to flash flooding and leaking roofs and so on.
As opposed to the quick and fast storm that we saw in Victoria in Melbourne last week, this one came hard and fast but stuck around. What's the focus of the cleanup this morning?
Just completing those jobs, those leaking roofs that were impacted in the Sydney Basin. We had a lot of jobs in the hills area in the northwest of the Sydney Basin. Obviously, some of those properties are a little bit more remote and on acreages, so they're a bit harder to get to. So a lot of downed trees as well. So still just cleaning things up, but the teams will be out there, or are out there now, completing those outstanding jobs from yesterday.
Yeah, well, I hope they stay safe out there. Angus, to you, there was more than 100,000 lightning strikes yesterday. Is that normal? I mean, four people struck at once in and around the city area where you've got tall buildings and lightning rods. What's going on?
Yeah, morning, Trevor. Morning, everyone. It was an incredible amount of lightning yesterday. As you say, tens of thousands of strikes around the Sydney area. And more broadly, looking at close to a million lightning strikes across New South Wales, southern Queensland and adjacent coastal areas through 24 hours up to this morning. So it's an incredible amount of lightning. It's not the most we've ever seen, but it's certainly more than just a standard stormy day.
So is there more wild weather on the way?
Yeah, it looks like there is going to be more hit and miss showers and thunderstorms each afternoon this week, primarily focused on New South Wales. That means those places in southeast Queensland, like Brisbane, maybe getting a few brighter and drier days, but a little further south across New South Wales, continuing to see those showers and storms. And I think if we look through the rest of the week, the 2 days I'd be flagging as having the potential to bring more severe storms would be today, Tuesday, and then again on Friday, with a couple of calmer days in between.
While I've got you on the other side of the country, you've been tracking a cell, haven't you? Fears the cyclone could redevelop. What's going on there?
Yeah, this is ex-tropical cyclone Lincoln, which was a tropical cyclone for a very short window of time late last week before crossing the Northern Territory border and going into a tropical low. It's now moving westward, and as we speak at the moment, it's crossing the border between Northern Territory and now into WA, across that Kimberley area in Northern WA. Tomorrow, it's likely to cross the coast and move back over the ocean. And once it's over those warm oceans to the north of the country, there's a pretty high chance it will redevelop back into a tropical cyclone. So it would become tropical cyclone Lincoln once again by about the middle of this week. And after that, we're tracking the possibility that it could move towards the far west of the country, somewhere near Exmouth, towards the end of this week or possibly this weekend, bringing significant rain there.
Mother Nature keeping us guessing. Thank you, gents.